What is Apple, John?
It's a company we're setting up which involves records, films, electronics, which make records and films work, and what's it called, manufacturing?
Yeah, it does a few things.
We hope to make a thing that's free, where people can just come and do and record and not have to ask, could we have another microphone in the studio, because we haven't had a hit yet.
Suddenly he was a record company avowedly owned and run by these working class boys from Liverpool. We determined that it wouldn't be as hidebound and as respect-oriented and as boring as record companies were. How we signed each of the artists we did sign are each kind of separate stories, and actually each very different kinds of stories.
There's something in the way she moves that looks my way or calls my name.
James Taylor was a coincidence. I mean, James came to me through a mutual friend. Monkey, so happens I've just started work at this brand new record label. So I said, you know, come and sign with the record label. And that's what happened. It was quite fast and quite simple.
She's around me now almost all the time. And if I'm well, you can tell she's been with me now.
The songs for the first album were mostly the songs off the demo tape. Carolina in My Mind was not on the demo tape. He wrote that subsequently.
In my mind, I'm gone to Carolina. Can't you see the sunshine? Now can't you just feel the moonshine? And ain't it just like a friend of mine to hit me from behind? Yes, I'm gone to Carolina in the mind.
Around that same time, Twiggy had called Paul and said, you must turn on your television, this girl is remarkable. She was watching Mary Hopkin. When Paul signed Mary Hopkin, he already knew he wanted to produce the record. I knew the song, he wanted to make the first single. So he had a plan in mind the day we signed it.
Those were the days, my friend. We thought they'd never end. We'd sing and dance forever and a day.
That was Mary Hopkin.
Maybe tomorrow I will. Mal Evans, who was the Beatles' road manager, brought in the Ivies on tape to an A&R meeting. They had one minor hit in America with Maybe Tomorrow.
Maybe tomorrow I will love again.
Then I think the general feeling was that maybe the Ivies was kind of a wimpy name. And Neil Aspinall, to the best of my recollection, suggested Badfinger as a new and groovier name.
No matter what you are, I will always be with you.
I'd met Billy Preston before, and I'd also heard him play with Ray Charles, and he was invited by George, I think, to play on one of these sessions. And everyone's affection for him and admiration for his musicianship and his songs grew to him getting a deal with Apple Records.
That's the way.
Records was an adventure at the time, and it obviously continued to exist to this day. You know, as labels go, the ratio of good to crappy is a very good one. We were a label. We did succeed in some of our aims.
If you want it, here it is. Come and get it.